Welcome students, I am N.K. Tukral from Edupedia World. Students, we have already discussed the various forms of organizations in the previous sessions. The details such as features, merits, demerits, etc. were talked about, and I suppose that everybody now is well aware of all type of organizations. That is sole proprietorship, partnership, HUF business, cooperative society, and about joint stock company. But friends, even after that, what I still feel to give you the important tips which helps and will make you confident to answer the questions asked in the final examinations. The variety of questions can be asked and answers of which needs to be given either in brief or in one sentence or in detail. Unless you have gone through the full chapter, I mean to say right from the definition to features, merits and limitations of a subject, you will not be able to answer the questions accurately. So I would like to emphasize that never the answer should be given in general. Rather, you should be very specific and to the points while answering the questions. If so, you will get very good marks if your answer is specific to the questions. If one word answer or one sentence answer is required, give only one word or one sentence answer. And where explanation is required, that needs to be given also very specifically. So friends, let me now take up one by one. I will discuss with you on various model questions and suggest you as how to write the answers. So friends, now let me talk first on application based questions where answers are required to be given very specifically. Number one question as a model sample is, although company is an artificial person, it can still own property and enter into contracts. Now you need to defend the statement or refute the statement. But here you can see in the slide there are two type of questions have been asked in one question. That is, company is an artificial person. Second is, it can still own property and enter into contracts. Now you have to go back to the joint stock company definitions and features. You will find the answer there itself. Since the company is an artificial person, it cannot breathe, it cannot sleep, it cannot talk, but still it can still own property and enter into contracts. Now how is it possible? Both statements are correct. How to answer now? You have to write clearly, it is true that company is an artificial person as it is created by law. However, like a natural person, a company can also own property and enter into contracts, but through BOD, that is Board of Directors. So being an artificial person, company enters into contracts through its Board of Directors. Board of Directors enters into an agreement with others and indicates company's approval through a common seal. That's all. That is the correct answer against this question. Nothing more, nothing less. Now, second question is, even though registration of partnership firm is not compulsory, but still partners prefer to get it registered. Why? You need to give reason also that in case of partnership firms, registration is not at all compulsory. But why partner prefer? Now you have to go back to the partnership and find out the answer. Answer you will find out when we studied non-registration. What are the consequences of non-registration? You will find answer there. Very specifically, you have to write with reasons the following type of answer. However, non-registration deprives the firm from a number of benefits. The consequences of non-registration are as follows. Number one, a partner of an unregistered firm cannot file a suit against the firm or other partners. That is a benefit. Second benefit, the firm cannot file a suit against third parties. Third is, the firm cannot file a case against the partners. So, reason you have to ask, these are the three reasons why partners prefer to get the firm registered. So, this is a sample answer against the question. Next is, question is, promoter is not a trustee of the company, but he stands in a fiduciary relationship. Now, again, you have to go back to the joint stock companies where we have discussed on incorporation of the company on the first stage, that is promotion of the company. What exactly you should write here on the promoter's duties or promoter's as a trustee? So, what you have to write, the given statement is true. Promoter is a trustee of the company. However, he stands in a fiduciary relationship. Relationship means of utmost faith with the company he is promoting. He should not misuse his position, that is, he should not carry out any activity which is against the interest of the company. For example, he should not make any secret profit in the dealings, and if he makes, then such profit should be disclosed. So you have to write that the statement is correct, but he stands in a fiduciary relationship. Now, next students, next question is, sample question is, you can see in the slide that Smart Limited invited general public to subscribe for its public issue of 10 crore within bracket 1 crore share into rupees 10 each, through issue of prospectus. However, the company unable to receive the minimum subscription. Now, question is, can the company proceed with the allotment of shares? As students, you have already gone through against general stock company on commencement of business, where it is clearly written what is the importance of minimum subscription. You must understand that minimum subscription is very much necessary in case a company wants to commence its business. So once it's clear to you, you will simply answer that no, Smart Limited cannot proceed with allotment of share as minimum subscription has not been received. In such case, allotment cannot be made and application money received must be refunded to the applicants. So you need to answer also that allotment cannot be made and application money also, you have to write it, received must be returned to the applicants. So friends, these were the questions, sample questions on application based questions. Second category of questions can be in the examination on multiple choice of questions. That means choices are with you, you have to simply mark the ticks against the right choice. But before that, I must tell you that you must have in your mind that what is the definition of a particular item, what is the features, what are the merits and demerits, you will find automatically the answers. Now let us take number one question. The structure in which there is separation of ownership and management is called partnership or sole proprietorship or all business organization or a company. So here you have two words in this question, ownership and management, means their separation. Now, can it be possible in sole proprietorship? No. Can it be then the partnership? No. Because in case of partnership, partners are the responsible and they can do. Whereas sole proprietorship, owner has all the powers. There is no separation of ownership and management. So the answer is company. You have to mark the tick against company. Second is the karta in joint Hindu family business has limited liability or unlimited liability or joint liability. So friends, you must be knowing joint Hindu family business where karta has more onus of responsibility and more powers also. So he has the unlimited liability, whereas other members have limited liability. So you will find in the features of Hindu undivided family business that karta is the main karta of the business and it has the unlimited liability. Third is the minimum number of partners required are 3, 20, no limit or 2. This you will find in case of partnership where it is clearly written in the features that how many partners are required to start with the business. So answer you will get as a 2. Fourth is provision of residential accommodation to the members at reasonable rates is the objective of which society? Consumer cooperative, credit cooperative or housing cooperative. So here you can relate the residential accommodation with the type of cooperative society. You will find the answer, that is housing cooperative society. Next is minimum number of members to form a private company is either 3 or 2 or 7 or 5. So here simply when you know the definition of a private company and its features, you will find the answer, that is minimum number of members are required as 2. Next is minimum number of members to form a public company. Similarly, if you know how the private company is formed, what is the requirement, similarly in case of public company also, you will find the answer, that is minimum numbers are required at least 7. So you have to mark the tick against 7. So these type of questions you need to answer, provided you are very clear on definition features of the particular organization. Next is application for approval of name of company is to be made to whom, which authority. Blindly don't write at the government of India. Mind it, you have to just think about that company related to what, either it's SEBI or government of India or government of state. No, it is registrar of companies, because it is very clearly given in, against incorporation of a company, that all the formalities compliance is to be made with the registrar of company. So here application is also need to made registrar. You have to mark that as a registrar of companies. Now friends, let me tell you another category of question, short answer type questions. These type of questions are where you have to explain the things. What is being asked, what has been asked to you specifically, you have to simply explain that. For example, number one is, what is meant by partner by estoppel? Explain. As you can see in the slide, it is given, the question is, what is meant by partner by estoppel? Explain. Now students, I must tell you that what simply you have to write against this question. First, you have to define what is partner by estoppel, as we have read in the previous sessions on type of partners. Partners can be of different types. So one of the categories is partner by estoppel. So you have to define and then explain, and with example. One example at least you must give, that you will be able to explain. Second is, state the important privileges available to private company. Here students, you have to go back and in mind you think it, that what is private company, what is public company, why I need to form private company and why I need to form public limited company. So once it is clear, you will be able that certain benefits are given under Companies Act and privileges available to private company. So you can write only the important privileges required for a private company. Next is, what is prospectus? you need to defend and you need to explain what is prospectus. You have to define what is prospectus and is it necessary to file the prospectus for every company. You have to go back. Remember, against joint stock company, incorporation, commencement, where the prospectus need to be issued by a company, by public limited company, where the filing of the prospectus is required, or statement in lieu of prospectus is required where prospectus is not being issued. So this is also needs to be written, prospectus, and correlate with statement in lieu of prospectus. Next question is, explain perpetual succession, karta, artificial person, common seal. These are the short type of notes where the answers are required at least in 10-15 words. You can explain the thing, what is perpetual succession. Only you need to define and write few of the features of this, like karta. What is karta? You have to define. What are his function? What is his role? Third, artificial person, company. Company is an artificial person, but still it can end into contact. This needs to be written under artificial person. And common seal, what is the requirement of common seal? What is the importance of common seal? And where it is required to affixed. These things need to be written against these short notes. So friends, all questions we have discussed were the short answer type questions of ours. One thing again I would like to clear that wherever explanation is required, give at least 20-30 words, define it and give the features, your answer will be correct. Where only ticking is required, before marking the ticks, you must remember what is being asked and what exactly is required. Next category of questions are long answer type questions. So just now we have gone through the short type answers, where here is a long answer type question required. Number one example is, why is it important to choose an appropriate form of organization? Discuss the factors that determine the choice of form of organization. How the answer needs to be given against this question? One is asked, why is it important to choose an appropriate form of organization? Second is asked, discuss the factors that determine the choice of form of organization. What answer needs to be given against this? You have to write that there are various forms of organization and each form has its own merits and limitations. The survival and growth of business mainly depends on the selection of suitable form of organization. For factors that determine the choice of form of organization, you need to give all the factors where it is required, like nature of activity, area where the business needs to be started, or financial resources, etc. There are so many factors, all you need to write and explain at least with two or three sentences. Next type of question can be asked is, what is memorandum of association? Briefly explain its clauses. Here the question is very simple, but you need not explain too much. But you have to give what is memorandum of association of a company. You have to clearly write, it is a main charter of the company where all the object clause, registration clause, or whatever required needs to be given under memorandum of association. Then you have to explain its clauses. What is object clause? Why is it required? What should be written here? What are the sub clauses? All needs to be given under this question. Next is, what do you understand by a sole proprietorship form? Explain in merits and limitation. So it is also very simple. You have to first define what is sole proprietorship form, what is sole proprietor, and what is sole proprietorship form. Both, after defining both these words, you will be able to explain the things very clearly. And after giving features of sole proprietorship form, you must give merits as well as limitation of sole proprietorship. So answer should be given in such a manner that it covers fully the question, and secondly, explanation is also given so that teacher should understand what you want to write and what has been asked. So this is all, friends. I would like to again repeat that always be specific to the question and very clear in mind what needs to be given. Where explanation is required, must give proper explanation. Don't write here and there. So that's all today. Thanks. Bye-bye.